Welcome to Chaleigh TV,
the channel dedicated to indie artists and entertainment.
Tonight we're going to deep dive into a destroyed mind and find out what happens when we're identified by what we own, not to mention break the one rule. Talk about Fight Club. This film is such a fantastic. I love it so much, and the symbolism that is shown through the story and the way that, you know, David Fincher actually utilized all this stuff in the film. It was so just really sleek and sharp and downright gorgeous. This film was not a typical indie, but it got a massive cult following. It was actually backed by Fox. I was genuinely surprised that this film got a major production company to back it, because of the topics that were talked about in this film are very taboo topics for mainstream modern entertainment to talk about. They don't discuss them. So that was really unique and interesting, and probably why it got a cult following in the first place. This wicked story is about an insomniac that is feeling just destroyed, and he's dying on the inside.
I couldn't sleep.
No, you can't die from insomnia.
He feels trapped in, you know, consumer-driven life that he's in, and that probably what a lot of Americans feel like when they get a corporate job that they really aren't passionate about. After a while, that's going to take a toll on the human soul. So this was an interesting character that we got right off the bat with these kind of problems. This character is a little different from what we've seen in the other characters that had quote-unquote dead-end jobs, or soul-sucking jobs, because this character doesn't complain about his job. He doesn't do anything big or grand ever to really... No, this is an entirely different character that is very, very crippled, handicapped by loneliness, depression, and emptiness that is going on inside of him.
I need to deprioritize my current reports until you advise of a status upgrade.
Make these your primary action items.
The film's take on mental health is very unique because it deals with, you know, culture as a whole and our society as a whole. If Clerks was about young adults being stuck at dead-end jobs, feeling no direction or purpose, this film is not necessarily about a dead-end job, but a corporate sellout job that we need in our society to play house in order to afford all the consumeristic shit. The society says that's the only way you're going to be accepted in life.
I'd flip through catalogs and wonder, what kind of dining set defines me as a person? This is your life, and it's ending one minute at a time.
Now, we watch this character evolve or devolve, depending on your perspective. Some argue that he snaps and creates an alter ego. Some argue that he has always been this way. Some say that he's a manifestation of his own actual desires, that what he wants. Some may argue that he was always that way, he just didn't know it. Now, no matter what your own personal theory is, please put in the comment section below. I can't wait to hear that. I think we can all agree that Tyler is the bigger, stronger, hotter version of the narrator of, you know, Edward Norton's character.
All the ways you wish you could be, that's me. I look like you want to look, I fuck like you want to fuck, I am smart, capable, and most importantly, I'm free in all the ways that you are not.
He is the epitome of what the main character wants. The narrator and the alter ego create a secret society known as Fight Club for men to come and take out their aggressions through their primal instinct through physical combat. That is an entire subject that never ever gets talked about ever in a film. Hell, I think it's very politically incorrect now to even bring it up in a film. I have a little secret from a primal women. We like seeing the guys this way. We're not allowed to say that either. It's considered all kinds of things: sexist, toxic, barbaric. Despite all that crap, the reality of the situation is men and women have primal instincts. Whether society acknowledges them or accepts them or not, we do have them. They are there. Now, the club becomes a way of for the men to redefine their identity and rebel against the constraints of conventional masculinity in modern society. It also becomes a way for them to push their own limits and see their actual capabilities outside of cultural norm.
Anywhere like you were there. But Fight Club only exists in the hours between when Fight Club starts and when Fight Club ends. Even if I could tell someone they had a good fight, I wouldn't be talking to the same man. Who you were in Fight Club is not who you were in the rest of the world. A guy came to Fight Club for the first time, his ass was a wad of cookie dough. After a few weeks, he was carved out of wood.
Unfortunately, the narrator and his alter ego do find out the hard way that there's a fine line between liberation and self-destruction. There's also, without a doubt, a serious downfall to letting the voices in your head or the emotions inside of you take full control. Edward Norton's character doesn't even know where he be.
You fucking talk to her about me.
Like, what the fuck is going on here?
I ask you for one thing. One simple thing.
Why do people think that I'm you?
Answer me! Sit.
Answer me, why do people think that I'm you?
I think you know.
No, I don't.
Yes, you do. Why would anyone possibly confuse you with me? Got it.
No.
Do not fuck with us!
Say it.
Because.
Say it.
Because we're the same person.
That's right.
We are the all singing, all dancing crap.
I don't understand this. You were looking for a way to change your life. You could not do this on your own.
The narrator is too busy trying to find fulfillment in extreme rebellion without ever, you know, thinking about the inevitable consequences that will come of it. He did indeed get instant gratification from getting back at his society, but it did cost him everything, including his own sanity. We all want a Tyler in our life. Our alter egos make things far worse than we ever could have imagined.